But what was that process losing your dad at 5 years old when you only remember so much?
Well, I think also there's some real differences right off the bat. Being 12 is way harder than five because you're moving into sort of those formative years where you're going to start developing more of your own beliefs and how the worldview is. And then something serious like that happens. It's sort of like why divorce is much harder for a 12, 13, 14, or 15 year old than a little kid. So starting with that. Secondly, you know, your dad went to work that day and didn't come home. I actually was not living with either one of my parents when my dad died. I was living with childhood neighborhood friends. My mother's from Long Island. So neighborhood friends that they'd hang out. And they were a couple. I was not genetically linked to them, but I called my aunt and Uncle Joe. And they, I remember I was sitting in my room and the phone rang. Because it's, you know, no, it's landlines. And so I remember the tone in my aunt Rhett's voice, and I knew something was wrong. And so then she came into my room, and I was sitting in my bed, and she had told me. So it's a different sense of loss. Also, I think there's something really different about, I saw my daddy put me to bed, or I said goodbye to him when he went to work, and then he didn't come home. Mm. I think that is even more, there's something where the rug really gets pulled out, where I was almost a little more accustomed to some space without these people in my life.
Yeah, I think the way I look at it is there's differences, but not to say which one is.
Want me to be really sad? Is that it?
I mean, I was hoping you'd cry by now. It's only been 4 minutes. I'm actually disappointed.
No, listen. Of course, I think we all want to know where we come from. Hmm. So maybe you have a greater sense of that than I. Had the opportunity because you, do you know what I'm saying? Like, yes. Oh, I knew my dad and he, you know, would do this on the weekends or whatever. I didn't know. I knew my dad when he would come to visit. And also, for what this is worth, I think a lot of what, I think there's a lot of things I inherited from my father that I can feel intuitively have guided me. Because there's certain personality traits and certain things that because there were some very difficult times, we all have them. I think those things actually were some of the things that guided me through.
Like what?
Just certain traits, personality traits. I even look, I have the kind of size of my mother. And then, from here to here, I look very similar to my father. So I think there was ways I could connect by looking at photographs. Because again, no cell phones. So it's not like hours and hours of logged videos and things of a person. And so there's a lot of data suggesting that you kind of do one of two things when you lose a parent. If you're a daughter losing a father, you become the kind of male figure to yourself. Or, you know, you go on a tear, right? Looking for love or things like that. So I probably did versions of both growing up.
Were you able to identify that? You know what I mean? Did you bring it all the way back to your father immediately?
No, definitely not. Just being a teenager and being rebellious and like, he thinks I'm pretty and he's being nice to me and that's male energy and attention. I'm going to sort of find that way to have that energy for myself. And so, and again, then it gets accentuated. I go into sports, then I go into professional sports, certain natural personality traits where you sort of kind of try to house that for yourself. And then I met Laird at 25, which is pretty young adult. And he's obviously has a lot of masculine energy. And I probably was drawn to that for a lot of reasons.
So everything you just explained, do you think that's part of the grief process? Like what do you define your grief process as, losing your father so young?
You know, I have to be honest, I had another battle I was fighting, which was I wasn't with my mom. So I was battling kind of different things.
Which is a sense of grief, you know? It's on a bite, maybe it's
not. Yeah, so I don't know that I could just put it onto one thing. I think I was sort of trying to navigate not feeling secure and feeling like who was going to take care and what was going to happen. And it showed up in in a lot of ways. So it showed up in overcompensation. It showed up in, I went to college at 17. I started modeling at 18. I bought a townhouse at 19. Right. Why did I do that? I was looking for roots, security, a place that I knew was going to be there. So those are all coming out of, because when we are not experiencing, if we're not feeling grief or something, I think we roll with it more. Mm. We're not trying to lock everything down and organize it and know what it is, because that's just a false sense of I'm in control.
Such is life.
Yeah. You know what I mean? And I think, so my grief showed up in overcompensation, overperformance, over, I look to the future, like anticipating every, all things that could happen or go wrong and having always backup plans and things like that, which serves you really well and is a total bullshit, right? Like yeah. It's just, it doesn't really exist. So it's like, then you're undoing. My grief and all of that was more about like trying to undo all that. I, you know, maybe I made a certain part of my personality feel good and still for a minute, but it also creates a lot of limitations. Mm. So how do you have the wherewithal and the sense of, hey, it's all really scary and that's okay. Because when you experience loss early, you know, they talk about attachment styles. Well, one of them is in a detached way. And that certainly was the way I did it.
Attached.
Detached.
Detached. Okay,
that makes right, because it's like, oh, you're going to leave, or whichever that way that means. In my case, it was you're going to leave out the door and you're going to leave.
Yeah.
You're going to die. And so then you have to get to a place where you're like, wait a second, am I going to love and risk and do all these things that are really scary to me? If you want to build a life that has, you know, color and possibility, I think you have to let go.
Yeah, it's much easier said than done. And I was just talking to someone, excuse me, about letting go. And I want to kind of go backwards to something that you said that stood out when I asked you what was your grief process and you started bringing up your relationship with your mother and mm-hmm. it was hard to identify. You know, normally I feel like I'd even ask the importance of identifying it, but then I realized it's not important. I think what you did is relating to that in that it was tough to identify, and therefore, since it was tough to identify, you weren't able to identify, but you were able to identify the emotions regardless.
Yep.
And that's key.
Yeah. I think there was levels of that. I think you do a version of, because it's also survival and it's hierarchy of needs and importance. So when you're young, it's like, oh, I have to get through school. Okay, now I'm going to move back with my mom. Now I have to try it as a young adult to build a life. And then as maybe you start to live life, you go, oh, wait, there's some other things that I need to deal with. And those then move from the bottom of the list and they sometimes move higher. I think, you know, and then you have kids and then it becomes important for a different reason. Because it's like, hey, I don't want to pass this on or have this limit me as sort of this loving parent. Because I have these things. So when you're in survival mode, it's one thing. Yeah. And then I think as you get a little bit of space, if you get that opportunity, that's why if you think about it, people that come from really tough areas and they're experiencing loss all the time, but they don't get the luxury and the space to really take a look at it. Because there's no, you know, their foot's always on the gas of, hey, I got to survive.
Yeah.
I got to get through this. I still have to work. I still have to keep the lights on. For me as a young adult, I got a little bit of runway and it was like, oh, okay, I can start to just take a look at this.